Good morning. I'd like to welcome everyone to our Ellenville Elementary 6th grade moving up. It is so great to see everyone. My name is Nicole I. I am the very proud principal of the elementary building. It's a very exciting day here today for the 6th graders and all the parents, friends, family, and teachers here today. It's always a pleasure to see so many parents and special guests at our celebrations each year. Just a few reminders before we begin. Emergency exits are to your left and to your right and through the back doors. If at any time you need to make a phone call or something like that, please make sure that you exit those doors. Restrooms are also outside the auditorium door and across the hall if you need that. We're gonna keep this as official as we can. So we're gonna ask that all cell phones go off. We are also live streaming this, so you can go back at any time at the Ellenville YouTube channel to see this, and it's also being live streamed right now. We ask that you stay seated and are respectful at all times, and that you enjoy today. At this time, I'd like to introduce to you William Turner and Rolf Leland.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and the National Anthem. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated. Oh, no. Do you want me to say please stand for the National Anthem? Please stand for the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watch were so gallantly streaming. Still there, oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
thank you to Miss Denise Younger, who gets me every time. Thank you. Okay. At this time, I'd just like to say a few words to the sixth graders. I'd like to welcome again our guests, faculty members, administrators, board members, proud parents, and most importantly, the sixth grade class of 2023. It's with great pleasure that I stand before you today to celebrate the moving up ceremony of our sixth graders. This event marks the closing of the time in your journey at the elementary school and the beginning of a new chapter of your academic career. To the students and the class of 2029, I want you to know that this is your moment. I've had the privilege of watching you grow since first grade. You faced challenges and triumphed over obstacles. Now, as you stand in the doorway to your junior high, you have a unique opportunity, one shot, to define yourselves and embrace the possibility that lies before you. In the coming years, you will encounter new subjects, face different expectations, and be introduced to new activities. Embrace these opportunities. Discover your passions, explore your talents, and dare to dream big. Engage in sports, arts, music, drama, clubs, and immerse yourself in new experiences. As you start this new journey, remember that success comes with challenges. There may be moments of doubts, setbacks, and failures along the way, but you can learn and grow from your difficult times and use them as a fuel to move forward. As you leave the familiar hallways of the elementary school, know that we believe in you. We are confident in your abilities to excel. You are capable of greatness, and it's your time to shine. Embrace the challenges, cherish your friendships, and savor every moment of this incredible journey. Let's take a moment to acknowledge the educators who have guided you on this journey. Their dedication, expertise, and support have shaped you into the individuals you are today. Let's give them a large round of applause. I'd like to also applaud the parents and guardians who have stood by your side. Their support, encouragement, and love have been invaluable to your growth. Thank you to all the family members and friends who have cheered them on from the sidelines as well. Congratulations, class of 2029 and 2023 from the elementary building. May your future be filled with success, joy, and possibilities. At this time, I'd like to invite the sixth grade band to the stage, directed by Mrs. Christina Schoonmaker. I'd love to give another round of applause. I'm always blown away by the music, talent, and the sixth grade band led and directed by Miss Christina Schoonmaker. At this time, we're going to begin one round of our awards. At this time, I would like to, these are some special presentation awards. I'd like to call to the stage Mr. Grigliano.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Mr. Grigliano. I am one of the phys ed teachers for the sixth grade this year. I want to start out by thanking the sixth grade teachers, the administrators, and the office staff for working with us this year. We have ever-evolving schedules in phys ed. What gym we're going to be in always changes, so it's nice that they're always willing to work with us. This year's group of sixth graders is one of the most competitive group of students I've ever worked with. Mat ball, basketball, or the brand new Gaga ball we introduced at Field Day, it doesn't matter the game, this group always wanted to win. Last year I said the sixth graders were the most intense group I've ever seen. Well, this group took the cake this year and took over that crown. It's going to be fun to see what this group does when they can start wearing blue and gold and competing together next year for our school's teams. Everyone remember, it doesn't matter who you are, what you look like, how competitive you are, or how experienced you are, there's a spot in a sport for you here at Ellenville. Try something out. Fall sports sign-ups start in the summer. Get on family ID, get signed up, and get ready for practice when school starts in September. You are at a moment right now where you get to choose what you want to do as you move up to the junior high school. It's your first chance to be a student athlete. It takes hard work and dedication, not just to sports, but in the classroom as well. For this group, it was difficult to choose just two people for the PE award. There were so many deserving candidates. We chose two young people who not only are skilled as show promise as athletes, but more importantly, show great sportsmanship and leadership qualities. I look forward to hopefully being able to continue to work with these two as they move on to the junior senior high school. The physical education award winners for the 22-23 school year are Sam Dickman and Haley Benjamin.
At this time, Mrs. Schoonmaker is going to join us at the podium for the band award.
Good morning. My name is Christina Schoonmaker. I am the sixth grade band director. I'd like to also thank the sixth grade teachers for all of their support all year, helping our students remember their instruments and helping remember their lesson time and being just an amazing team to work with. It's been a pleasure, so thank you. We had a wonderful second year of band. I am so proud of all that we've accomplished in this year, and I can't wait to work with these students more when they're in the seventh and eighth grade band in the fall. This particular class had to start last year wearing a mask due to COVID restrictions. We couldn't see their faces to help correct anything. It was a really difficult time to start playing an instrument, and these students persevered and stuck with it even though it wasn't easy, so we're particularly proud of them. It was difficult for me to choose just two high-achieving band students because they're all high achievers. Between practicing at home and arriving at school an hour early twice a week for rehearsals, all band students truly go the extra mile. In addition to these students being great Ellenville sixth grade band students, this year's band award winners both auditioned and were accepted into the Ulster County Elementary All-County Band, and both received ratings of outstanding, the highest you can earn, on their solos at the New York State School Music Association Solo Festival. Congratulations to our 2023 band award recipients, Matthew Henry and Isabella Velasquez.
Thank you.
Next, I'm going to have Mrs. Matola and to present the art award. Mrs. Muller is not here to join us, but she is also the other art teacher.
Good morning. Most of you know me as Miss Amy. I'm here to present the art award on behalf of Miss Muller and myself. As a whole sixth grade, I've been very proud of the ways you've all grown as artists and learned to find your voice through all the centers we've used through this year. You guys are the first group that I've had since kindergarten, so I have seen you from little up all the way. I hope that you take what you've learned here and keep practicing and never be afraid to try new things or to challenge yourself. The award winners are chosen for having the strong hand, heart, and mind of an artist. In the studio, we talk about how these three qualities must come together to be successful. The hand refers to the understanding of how materials work and can be used to make something. The mind refers to an artist's ideas and how they plan out their projects. The heart refers to the care and the effort the artist shows towards their artwork and, in general, towards others. It is my honor to celebrate the accomplishments of this year's winners for their hard work and creative efforts. They are Giovanni Robles and Isabella Velasquez.
Next, Mrs. Marusik is going to join us for music and chorus.
Good morning. Hi, my name is Margo Marusik. I'm so pleased to have joined Ellenville School District this year as choral music teacher. I have the wonderful opportunity to honor four students in the area of music today. The two students receiving our music award have done a great job in general music class this year. In the course of this academic year, students have been developing performance skills and music literacy skills, creating as well as responding to music. Music is science, music is math, music is a phys ed, music is an art. Music is how we can relate and connect to others. It has so many benefits in addition to music for music's sake. These students not only excelled in effort, they also showed skilled musicianship. In music class, they are wonderful contributors. They actively participate in class. They are often the first to turn in any assignments, and they set an example for classroom behavior. These are talented, hardworking, and smart young musicians. And I am pleased to announce this year's music award to Braden Blakesley and Emmeline Wilkie. The two students receiving our choral award this year have made an impact on our fifth and sixth grade choral ensemble at Ellenville Elementary School. The first recipient reads music well, can be counted on for his performance of parts in our alto section with good intonation and rhythm. He participated in the Ulster County Music Educators Association All-County Choral Festival in March, and his commitment to chorus has been excellent this year. Our next recipient has been an important member of our chorus this year, also as an alto. Early in the year, I noticed this student showed a big desire to perform. Her voice has the potential to open up a new world of experiences in the arts. She has a beautiful voice and focuses on quality singing. She is talented, hardworking, and a smart young woman. And I've been very blessed to have her sing with our fifth and sixth grade chorus at Ellenville Elementary School. This year's recipients of the Choral Award are Brian Provost and Journey Thorpe.
Next, I'd like to recognize our student council officers for this year for their dedication to our students. President Donovan Ernst and Secretary Jasmine Garcia Reyes. Next, we're going to recognize a personal growth award, and to the podium, we're going to have Ms. Hemstreet, our school counselor, and Mrs. Westbrook, one of our social workers.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Andrea Hemstreet. I'm the sixth grade school counselor.
And I'm Kathy Westbrook, the social worker for the sixth grade.
We were asked to select four students who have shown personal growth in our Ellenville Elementary School.
These four students have not only demonstrated personal growth, but leadership qualities, integrity, and resilience. We would like to welcome to the stage first, Jesse Dinnerstein and Sebastian Hollenbach.
We would also like to welcome Noemi Mandeville and Mason Sullivan.
Nice job, Mike.
Good job.
Nice job.
Good job, Mason. I'm so proud of you.
Before we introduce the next award, I just want to introduce a few people on stage here. To my left in front of you, the person you're probably wondering who's handing out all these awards is Ms. Heather Heidelberg. She's our assistant principal for our fourth through sixth grade students. She has spent countless hours with our fourth, fifth, and sixth grade students this year and has gotten to know them very well. Also, to my left in front of you is Mrs. Meredith Smith, who is our other assistant principal. I'm going to now call to the podium Ms. Heidelberg and SRO Torres.
Right now, we are recognizing our Community Leadership Award from SRO Torres. This award recognizes students who consistently adhere to our code of conduct. They lead by example, they model positive behavior, effective self-management, and respect for themselves and others. Can I please have Carlos Melendez and Terrell Skinner?
Next, I'd like to recognize students that received the Triple C Award. Their teachers chose one student from each class who have recognized and demonstrated outstanding courage, character, and commitment by excelling in academic pursuits, participating in community service, displaying leadership among classmates, and/or overcoming personal challenges to inspire and provide hope for the future. I'd like to recognize the following students: Emma Beckley, Haley G. Michael, Matthew Henry, Dyer Lampley, and Journey Thorpe.
I'm now going to present our Citizenship Award for students who have shown kind words, respectful and helpful actions, positive attitude towards others, strength of character, and the courage to do what is right. The characteristics we hold to instill in all of our students as good citizens of our world. Carlia Adams. Francis Adams Faison. Mason Birchtold, Braden Blakesley, Micah Kaba, Nathaniel Caban, Donovan Ernst, Anais Forrester, Juliana Francois, Emmanuel Garcia Martinez, Jack Garrett, Mackenzie Goff, Meredith Hockheim, Uni Kim, Hunter Labonte, Dyer Lampley, Safara Maldonado, Isabel Martinez, Juliana Martinez, Maya Martinez, Carlos Melendez, Danielle Pitkin, Brian Provost, Giovanni Robles, Carmen Rodriguez, Lily Sales, Terrell Skinner, Journey Thorpe, Isabella Velasquez, Isaac Velez, and Emmalyn Wilkie. The next award we have is a Student Achievement Award by the New York State Comptroller. This is presented each year to a student who has excelled academically and has also shown leadership potential by volunteering his or her time to serve the school or community. Congratulations to all those students who are receiving State Comptroller Thomas P. DiNapoli Student Achievement Award for outstanding academic and leadership performance. The Comptroller believes a good education and service in the community set the stage for our youth to achieve great things. We hope you will share Comptroller DiNapoli's congratulatory message below. We thank you for your interest. Thank you. So our awards are going to be for Sullivan Deshawn, Samuel Dickman, Uni Kim, Keegan Levine, and Isabella Velasquez. For the next two awards, or for my next award, I'm just going to ask if you please hold the applause till the end. This is our President's Outstanding Achievement Award. I'm going to read the letter from our president. Congratulations on receiving the 2023 President's Education Award. Jill and I are honored to join your family, friends, and teachers in recognizing this wonderful achievement. Over the past year, you worked hard, learned so much, and faced challenges head on. You stayed curious and fearless, and you persevered. I am proud of you, and I hope you are too. I truly believe that you are a part of a remarkable generation, one that is more gifted, talented, and tolerant than any before. That's why I know the future of our nation is bright. Young people like you will be leading it. Keep studying, believe in yourself, and know that there is no limit to what you can do. You can make a difference, lift our country up, and change the world. I look forward to all that you accomplish. Joe Biden. The following award will go to Carlia Adams, Grace Castro, Diamond Helmich, James Horvath, Athena Pereira, Noah Poole, Michaela Rowe, Thomas Schuler, Mary Soto Cruz, Mason Sullivan, Christopher Velez, and Jazara Williams. All of these students have shown academic growth in their sixth grade career. Going to present our President's Academic Excellence Award for students who have straight A's in sixth grade. Again, please hold applause until all names are called. Emma Beckley, Micah Kaba, Nathaniel Caban, Allison Christiana, Sullivan Deshawn, Samuel Dickman, Marcos Downs Rios, Anais Forrester, Haley Giamichael, Jasmine Garcia Reyes, Jack Garrett, Noah Greenland, Matthew Henry, Zoe Kalish, Keegan Levine, Keith Peterson Jr., Danielle Pitkin, Safara Maldonado, Juliana Martinez, Maya Martinez, Amir McKenzie, Giovanni Robles, Journey Thorpe, Isabella Velasquez, Isaac Velez, and Christian Veronic. Next is a special message from me. Good morning to our family and friends of our amazing sixth graders. I'm going to keep this short and sweet. To the sixth graders sitting before me, I hope you never forget the feeling you have right now, the excitement of starting a new chapter. It's okay to be nervous. It's okay to be uncomfortable with the unknown. But know this, we are rooting for your success. We will always be here for you. Many people in this room have watched you grow and morph into the ladies and gentlemen that you are today. I wish you nothing but the best in the future, and I look forward to cheering you on throughout your journey. Thank you.
Next, we're going to present the certificates to all of our students. We're going to have each class come up. What I'm going to ask is that you hold all applause until the teacher has called the last student's name, and then I'll give you that time to acknowledge your student on stage. At this time, I'm going to call Mrs. Bugelman's class to the stage with Mrs. Roldan and Ms. Kraft.
Prince Anderson. Frank White Driscoll. Diamond Helmich. Isabel Martinez. Xavier McNeil. And Kaylin Rodriguez.
Next to the stage, Mrs. Brush's class.
Remington Baisley. Damian Basden. Emma Beckley. Mason Birchtold. Yeah. Ariana Feliciano. Anthony Huffman. Yeah. Keegan Levine. Jelani Lockley. Safira Maldonado. Jose Morales. Cameron Murphy. Danielle Pickin. Noah Poole. Magnolia Raglan. Sierra Reagan. Yeah. Rasheem Richardson. Yeah. Thomas Schuler. Yeah. Terrell Skinner. Aria Snyder. Cam Stewart. And Nasir Stubbs.
Next, I'd like to call to the stage Ms. Jurganchuk's class.
Good morning, everyone. Allison Christiana, Sammy Cologne, Sullivan Deshawn, Donovan Ernst, Asia Fisher, Jasmine Garcia Reyes, Trayshawn Harris, Matthew Henry, Ariella Igartua, Giovanni Keener, Annalise Kiernan, Rolf Leland, Noemi Mandeville, Maya Martinez, Amir McKenzie, Peyton Millis, Liam Mortellaro, Allison Nunavero, Ophelia Pereira, Michaela Rowe, Layla Straub, Trayvon Torres, William Turner, John Wilson,
next to the stage, Mr. Finelli's class.
Carlia Adams. Francis Adams Faison. Micah Caba. Nathaniel Caban. Anais Forrester. Juliana Francois. Aaliyah Garcia. Emmanuel Garcia Martinez. Jack Garrett. Noah Greenland. Hunter Labonte. Carlos Melendez. Jade Ortiz. Keith Peterson Jr. Giovanni Robles. Carmen Rodriguez. Lily Sales. Mary Soto Cruz. Journey Thorpe. Isabella Velasquez and Isaac Velez.
Next to the stage, Miss Franz's class.
Eric Banger Jr., Braden Blakesley, Cameron Castano, Jesse Dinnerstein, Aiden Drake, Helen Escalante, Megan Espinal, Lucas Fox, Nicholas Jimenez, Aria Grau, Amelia Grenier. Yeah! Uni Kim. Yeah! Dyer Lampley. Yeah! Bella LaSanta. Yeah! Emmanuel Otero. Athena Pereira. Brian Provost Jr. Ruben Reyes. Bruce Rifflard Jr. Lexi Veronic. Ariante Williams. And Jazlyn Williams.
And last but certainly not least, Mr. Finelli's class. Mr. Martelli's class, sorry.
What did I say? What did I say? Oh, Finelli. Sorry, Joe. Sorry about that. You're going to call Mr. Finelli again to back up?
Haley Benjamin. Kwabena Boahan. Grace Castro. Samuel Dickman. Marcos Downs Rijos. Haley Giamichael. Mackenzie Goff. Meredith Hockheim. Wait. Sebastian Hollenbeck. James Horvath. Nicholas Jankite. Zoe Kalish. Caleb Crum. Manaya Marinas. Juliana Martinez. Mario Morales. Nathaniel Rivera. Jeremiah Stoltz. Mason Sullivan. Christopher Velez. Christian Veronic. Emma Lynn Wilkie. Jazara Williams.
Before I invite our next performance up, I want to just give the Ellenville Elementary Class of 2023 a big round of applause. Next, I'd like to invite our fifth and sixth grade combined chorus, directed by Mrs. Margot Marusik, to the risers.
We find out what we're made of when we
our fifth and sixth grade chorus. We have one more special guest before we wrap up our ceremony this morning. I'd like to call to the podium Mrs. Carrie Galloway. She is our junior senior high school assistant principal.
Good morning, everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, teachers, parents, and most importantly to the sixth graders, today we gather here to celebrate a significant milestone in your lives, the moving up ceremony from elementary school to junior high. It is a moment filled with mixed emotions as you say farewell to the familiar and you embark on a new chapter of your educational journey. I would like to first express how honored I am to stand before you today and would like to share that Miss Ireland, your soon-to-be principal, congratulates you as well in her absence. As you look back, I would like you to please cherish all the memories you have created throughout the years in elementary school. From your first day of school, do you remember? To the friendships you've developed. Remember the challenges you've overcome and the victories you have celebrated. Each step in your journey, every lesson, every decision you made, it has shaped you into the individuals you are today. But guess what? Your journey isn't ending, no. It's a brand new chapter in your book. And guess what? You get to create this story. What will be your narrative? What is going to be your story for the junior high career? How will you grow? What mistakes will you make? You have to expect mistakes. We're not perfect people. And what victories will we celebrate together? I look forward to celebrating the victories with you and helping you navigate this new chapter in your story. Before we go today, you owe a heartfelt thank you to your teachers whose guidance and unwavering support have helped you navigate this transformative period of your life. You owe a heartfelt thank you to the administrators who have had to be hard on you at times, but they did it with love and care. And last but not least, you owe a heartfelt thank you to your parents, guardians, and loved ones who support you day in and day out and who will be there in the years to come. So as you move up to the junior high, I know without a doubt that you are filled with excitement, anticipation, worry, and fear of the unknown. You stand at the threshold of a whole new world. And it's filled with opportunities for growth and discovery. I want to first tell you a brief story of a seventh grader who's a soon-to-be eighth grader in our district. And I'm not going to share his name, but he came to my office one day, plopped down on the chair, and just cried. I gave him a moment to get it out, and I sat there in silence. I eventually asked him, "What's troubling you right now?" He responded, "I don't want to grow up. I want to go back to elementary. This is all too much. I knew how to do the work before, but I was able to get by, but you know what? It's so much more subjects, assignments, and there was a lot more things on his plate. And he knew that it was going to get real, real quick. I agreed with him in that moment. And there will come a time where you all will have a moment where you realize, wow, a lot is expected of me. I do have to study for this test. I do need to complete my homework. Sometimes I may have to stay after school for extra help. Life is not easy. It will take hard work to get you across that finish line and to reach your goals. So after he finished crying and pouring out, we pulled up his Google Classroom, we looked at his missing assignments, and we created a schedule to help him get back on track. You know what it took? It took him sitting out of recess some days and going to the lunch detention room to do some work. It took staying after school sometimes, and it took communication and collaboration with his teachers. When you find yourself doing those things, you know that you have grown. We cannot run from our challenges. We need to roll up our sleeves, face them head on, and create a plan to move that mountain. It takes holding yourself accountable as well to sticking to the plan that you have created. So I don't say all of this, guys, and I'm talking to the sixth graders here. I'm not saying this to scare you. No, not at all. But I want to let you know it will be a little different. Academic subjects will become more challenging, but also you will have a chance to explore a wide range of interests, whether it's delving into science, expressing your creativity in the arts, or joining a sports team. Commit to embracing every chance to learn, grow, and explore your passions. Be resilient, the ability to bounce back when you get knocked down. Be adaptable, you have to be flexible. Change can be intimidating, but it's through challenges that you will develop your strength and character. So I would like our sixth graders to please repeat after me. Together we can create an environment where everyone feels valued and respected. Celebrate differences. Embrace the unique. We will work together. We will support one another. And we can achieve remarkable things. Thank you. Embrace the challenges and adventures that lie ahead with courage and determination. Congratulations, class of 2023. I have no doubt that each and every one of you will make your mark on the world, but make it a positive one. In the words of Eleanor Roosevelt, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. Believe in yourselves, pursue passion, and make a difference. Thank you and congratulations again.
Thank you, Ms. Galloway. Before we conclude, I'd like to wish all of my sixth graders the very best of luck at the junior high. Remember, our doors are never closed. We will always stay open if you need anything from us. Thank you for sharing this wonderful day with us, to all of their friends and family and parents.